ప్రాపర్ గైడ్ లైన్స్, ఒకవేళ హాస్పిటల్లో కావచ్చు ఇలాంటి నెసెసిటీ వచ్చినప్పుడు ఇలాంటి సెంటర్స్ పెట్టినప్పుడు కావచ్చు, ఏదైనా యాక్సిడెంట్ జరిగి ఇట్లా ప్రాణ నష్టం జరిగితే ఇండియన్ మెడికల్ అసోసియేషన్ ప్రకారం లేదంటే మెడికల్ ఎథిక్స్ ప్రకారం ఎట్లాంటి ప్రొసీడింగ్స్ ఉంటాయి సార్? లీగల్ గా కావచ్చు లేదంటే మెడికల్ ఫెటర్నిటీ నుంచి కావచ్చు.
దేర్ ఆర్ పబ్లిష్డ్ ఆర్టికల్స్, దిస్ ఇస్ నాట్ సంథింగ్ న్యూ. Fire accidents have happened in places like All India Institute of Medical Sciences. Fire accidents have happened in Gandhi Hospital in Hyderabad. Fire accidents have happened in lot of well-established hospitals. It is not the first time. Okay, and this is not a hospital, yes, mind you. Okay, and COVID-19 is a situation where there is no prior experience. It is an unprecedented situation where the best of the places in the world are not able to handle appropriately. And access is number one. Access is number one. Okay. And that's why he may have taken a hotel or some other place to provide an access, not that to make money out of it.
Yes.
And even today, in published articles, there are hospitals, government-run hospitals in Nellore or other places, where 80 to 90% of them have no fire licenses. That's a published article. It's not by me. Yes. It's published by medical journals, where the licenses, where the government-run hospitals have no fire licenses, let alone hotels. And that is not, that's not within the expertise of a medical professional. He went to school to study medicine, not to see whether a particular place can withstand a fire or not, to be on his side. I'm not belittling the incident. The incident should never have happened. And it is extremely, extremely sad for any life to be lost. Extremely sad. But it is not in his hand. It has happened. And when it has happened, you cannot judge by the accident. You have to judge by who he is, what he has done, and his past experience. If it is happening every month in his hospital, yes, then you should punish him. If it has happened one time in his whole life, then, I mean, everybody makes a mistake. Everybody makes a mistake. A train, a well-run train can run into an accident. That doesn't mean that the railway minister has to be put in prison. No. I mean, things like that happen. We don't want them to happen, but they are acts of God. They are not acts of human beings. And they should be looked in a way with balance to see what kind of record a person has, what is his track record, and all those things have to go. I'm not saying how you make a judgment or not, but as an individual, as a person who knows him, I feel very strong that his motives are not what you are or what is being presented in the public.
Sir, I think technical aspect తీసుకుంటే కోవిడ్ కోసం ఏర్పాటు చేసిన ఈ సెంటర్ అవటం వల్ల, స్పెషల్ ఎక్విప్మెంట్ అక్కడ పెట్టడం వల్ల, ఈ హాస్పిటల్లో ఉండే ఇన్ఫ్రాస్ట్రక్చర్ దానికి సూట్ అవ్వకపోవటం, లేదంటే ఎటువంటి షార్ట్ సర్క్యూట్ జరిగే అవకాశం ఉందంటారా, లేదంటే ఇది రెగ్యులర్ హాస్పిటల్ ఆ హోటల్లో జరిగిన ఉన్నా లేదంటే ఇన్ఫ్రాస్ట్రక్చర్ వల్ల జరిగిన
విత్ కోవిడ్ దేర్ ఇస్ ఎ లిటిల్ న్యూయాన్స్ ఇన్ దట్ సానిటైజర్స్ హావ్ టు బి యూస్డ్. ఐ డోంట్ నో వెదర్ వాట్ హస్ హ్యాపెండ్ దేర్. ఐ యామ్ నాట్ వాచింగ్ ఫర్ దట్. ఓకే, అండ్ సానిటైజర్స్ హావ్ 60% ఆఫ్ ఆల్కహాల్. ఓకే. And those kind of things can make these accidents more prone.
Yes.
Maybe, I mean, we have to be extra careful. But again, it is not an accident small incidents have not happened on an everyday basis or once a week or once in 2 weeks to think that this is a pattern rather than a one-time event. A pattern, obviously, yes,
yeah,
it is wrong. If it's a one-time event and it is very hard to predict, I don't think it is fair to treat a one-time accident with a routine thing and make an assassination of a character of a person.
Lockdown time lo complete medical fraternity, medical field ki sambandhinchina andarini kuda prapancham mottham pogurta vachindi. Sudden ga ilanti incident jarigina tarvata పూర్తిగా ఈ 30 ఏళ్లగా సంపాదించుకున్న పేరు కావచ్చు, హాస్పిటల్ కు ఉన్న రెప్యుటేషన్ కావచ్చు, ఒక ఇన్సిడెంట్ తో మొత్తం పూర్తిగా మారిపోయిన పరిస్థితి వచ్చింది. ఇలాంటి సందర్భంలో అదే ఫీల్డ్ కి సంబంధించి చాలా మంది డాక్టర్స్ బయటకు వచ్చి ఏం మాట్లాడకపోవటం చూస్తుంటే డాక్టర్ రమేష్ గారు ఒక్కళ్లే దీని గురించి ఫైట్ చేయాలా, అంత దుస్థితి ఎందుకు ఏర్పడింది అంటారు, ఎందుకు ఎవరు మాట్లాడలేకపోతున్నారంట?
I do not want to comment on why people are not talking.
Yes,
obviously people are afraid to talk what they have in their mind, otherwise people will talk, and that is common sense. I'm not saying that is what is happening, but common sense or logically people will talk, and if people are not talking, that means there is something that is preventing them to talk.
Okay,
people also have to be educated. Society practically is divided between rich and poor, but people have to understand a good cooperation between rich and poor is beneficial to the rich and beneficial to the poor. That kind of education is sadly lacking in our educational system. The concept of how a government works: the government represents the poor, but it has to negotiate with the rich so that the poor will be taken care of by the rich. And that is essentially the part of what a government has to do. But unfortunately, the stakeholders, that is the people, the government, okay, the rich, the poor, they do not play their portions of their roles very appropriately. Okay? The poor things that somehow the resources are coming to them. That's not true. The rich work and pay the resources to help the poor because they believe that everybody has to live together. And by living together, they all make progress in the way they live. And that understanding is not very well explained in developing nations.
Indian Medical Association డాక్టర్ గారికి ఉన్న హిస్టరీని బట్టి ఎటువంటి మచ్చలు లేవు, ఎటువంటి తప్పులు ఇంతవరకు జరగలేదు కాబట్టి ఇండియన్ మెడికల్ అసోసియేషన్ పర్సీవ్ చేసుకోనో లేదంటే మెడికల్ ఎథిక్స్ కమిటీ లాంటిది ఒకటి పర్సీవ్ చేసి ఇష్యూని ఏదైనా సాల్వ్ చేసే అవకాశం ఉందంటారా, లేదు అని అంటే కేవలం రమేష్ గారే దీని గురించి ఫైట్ చేయాల్సిన అవసరం ఉంది?
నో, ఐఎమ్ షూర్ ఇండియన్ మెడికల్ అసోసియేషన్ హస్ కమ్ ఫార్వర్డ్ అండ్ కార్డియాలజీ అసోసియేషన్ హస్ కమ్ ఫార్వర్డ్ అండ్ ది అసోసియేషన్స్ హావ్ రైట్ఫుల్లీ కమ్ ఫార్వర్డ్ టు సపోర్ట్ యు. అండ్ ఐఎమ్ షూర్ వెన్ ఇట్ కమ్స్ టు ఎ జుడిషియరీ ఆర్ ఎ జడ్జ్మెంటల్ యాటిట్యూడ్, ఈవెన్ జుడిషియరీ విల్ లుక్ ఎట్ ది ప్లస్ అండ్ మైనసెస్ ఆఫ్ ది సిచ్యువేషన్ అండ్ ఐఎమ్ షూర్ హీ విల్ బి ఎక్విటెడ్ ద. But to go through this trauma, to go through this thing, okay, even for a society it is lost. That is where I want to explain. Even for a society, okay, what the society is losing? The society is losing a person who has acquired knowledge,
yes,
and which is very important at this time. Even as the newspapers and as the media has been publishing recently, that compared to other states, we lack state-of-the-art hospitals. And that is why we are not able to provide the state-of-the-art medical care for COVID patients. How do state-of-the-art hospitals come? State-of-the-art hospitals come with technocrats like him, yeah, who had learned, who have accumulated that experience of building a state-of-the-art hospital and delivering the care. The care may be expensive, but even to deliver the care, how to map the delivery of care, not all people have that expertise. Some have political experience, some have medical experience, some have engineering experience, and this is an experience that is not easy to get. And he has acquired that over the last 20 years. And even if the fault is unintended, okay, in other countries, there is what is called as community service, yes, as a price to pay for intended or unintended mistakes. And you can utilize that kind of service for even unintended mistakes, rather than humiliating a person, rather than making his self-esteem low, rather than distracting the knowledge that he has acquired, rather than distracting the ability of him to create jobs, rather than distracting the ability of him to accumulate financial, physical assets to the state. To the state means to the society. He is not going to carry those assets when he passes away. Those assets are going to be with the state. And that is how the mindset has to be. I mean, the mindset has to be hold hand in hand to develop together, rather than me destroying you or you destroying me. I do not want to enter into judgmental things. I'm just saying how a society develops and what he has gone through to acquire this precious, what is called as character, and what do you get by destroying another's character?
ఈ ఇష్యూలో చాలా ఎమోషన్స్ ఉన్నాయి. ఎందుకంటే ఒకటి, ఆ ఇన్సిడెంట్ జరగటం అనేది ఎవరికైనా బాధాకరం, అది డాక్టర్ గారికి కావచ్చు లేదంటే అందరికీ కూడా అది బాధాకరమైన విషయం, అదొకటి అయితే. రెండోది, ఇన్నాళ్ళు సంపాదించుకున్న పేరుని క్యారెక్టర్ అసాసినేషన్, డాక్టర్ గారుగా మా రమేష్ గారు సంపాదించుకున్న దాన్ని క్యారెక్టర్ అసాసినేషన్ ఒకటి. దానికి తోడు ఎంతో కష్టపడి బిల్డ్ చేసుకున్న హాస్పిటల్ పేరు కూడా, రెప్యుటేషన్ కూడా పోయే అవకాశం.
ఐ డు నాట్ థింక్ ఎనీబడీ కెన్ స్టాప్ హిమ్ ఫ్రమ్ పర్ఫార్మింగ్ ద వర్క్ దట్ హి లవ్స్ టు వర్క్. I mean, the only reason I think people like him or people, successful people, do is because there is a passion for them to work. And that is their lifeline. Unless they hold the hand of another person and give them the comfort, the compassion, the care, and see happiness in their face, they do not get happiness. And that is what drives people like Ramesh to work, not money or anything else. Okay, money is the least of the things that he's concerned about. He's concerned about that joy that he gets by holding a hand of another person, by making him feel better, by lessening his pain, by curing, by making him happy with free of pain, and by giving him one more day of this beautiful life. That is what makes him happy, and nobody can take that away from him.
Please do subscribe Myra Media.
Please subscribe Myra Media. Subscribe to Myra Media.
Please like, share and subscribe to Myra Media for a lot of film news, gossips and hot news.
Please like, share and subscribe to Myra Media.
For more interesting updates, please subscribe to Myra Media YouTube channel.
For more updates, please subscribe to Myra Media.
So like, share and subscribe to Myra Media.